Hey everybody, I'm Schmirkadaber, and welcome back to everything. I'm trying to find my way back to where I began, and I gotta say, it's a struggle. I can't figure out how to get any smaller than this, how to descend any further than this. Give me everything when I'm not asking for it. There we go. Here's a smaller thing, silicon. I'm gonna go to this first, though, because I haven't been it yet. I am Saccharomyces cerevisiae, a fungus. Yeah. This is pretty brutal, I gotta say. This game, like, and these ideas, I must keep going. Bye 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 ba 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 ba. Yeah. This game is not making me feel any better about the universe. This is different to what it was a second ago, or I am. Okay, I need to find the freaking carbon again. Get smaller. I missed my opportunity, apparently. You can now descend into the Golden Gate. Like, that's where I want to go. Okay. Here's a thing that I haven't seen. Go, 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 fungus, go. You are so slow, fungus. I can hardly stand it. No! Make a connection, fungus! Where the hell did it go? There we go. Not really part of
if
all this.
If you're reared with a 20th century, or shall we say an early 20th century common sense, which is based on the philosophy of science of the 19th century, you regard yourself as an accident, a biological accident, in a stupid universe, which is mechanical, but has no feelings. A vast, pointless gyration of radioactive rocks and gas in which you happen to occur. Of course, if you don't have that point of view and you are more traditional, you look upon yourself as a child of God. And therefore, under authority. In other words, there's a big boss on top of all this. And you better watch your P's and Q's, because that Almighty is looking after you. With the attitude of this is going to hurt me more than it's going to hurt you. And when you look at the world in that image, or in the other image, that it's a stupid mechanism, either point of view you take, you don't really belong. You are not really part of all this. Or to put it in the strongest possible way, it is quite alien to our thought that the external world, which is defined as something that happens to you, and your body itself as something that you got caught up with, it is quite alien to consider all that as you yourself. Because you see, we have such a myopic view of what one's self is.
Oh, indeed. Indeed. Like, all of this stuff makes sense. Like, it makes perfect sense. But it's very difficult to think about it. I'm getting trophies like freaking crazy, ladies and gentlemen, as well. And at least this guy is a little bit faster. But I'm struggling to get any smaller than this particular oeuvre, I guess. Come here, I love protozoans. Aw, okay. But I want to get smaller, dude. I want to get smaller is where I want to get to. Because I kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And I just can't seem to freaking spot. There we go. Something around here will make me small. Okay. You. I'm even smaller now. Some sort of spiral jobber. Let's all team up and do a little dance, make a little love. Yeah. I am Mycobacterium. Okay. Cool. I'm down with Mycobacterium. Let's go over here to this cloud and see if we can't get smaller. I need to get small, everybody. Fight me! I don't want to fight you. Okay. I would rather join you. That's nice. All right. Again, I can get bigger, but I'm struggling to find a way to get smaller. I know that I can find carbon because I found it before, but I chose to switch to something else because I hadn't had it. Aha! I swear I just swam past some. It looked just like it did before, but maybe I'm wrong. Okay. Just moving around. Just going, going, going. Onwards, onwards, forever. In big circles. Not finding any ability to descend. Like, I feel like I'm trapped here right now. I could potentially get bigger. My go back to the beginning thing has disappeared too. Alright, I'm gonna get bigger. I'm just gonna get bigger. Get me the fuck out of here. Get me out of this place. Get me back to regular old land, please. Alright. Here we go. Here's a thing I haven't been yet as well. Good. And I can get even bigger now. Very nice. Good, good. And should be able to get even bigger. Here we go. Where do I need to look to get bigger? A Bedouin tent. There we go. Big. And here. Now, I've lost my, like, golden gate thing. I don't know how to get... I don't know how to get back. I don't know. Which is like... Whoa! I am wildebeest. Alright. Which is terrifying, this idea of not knowing how to get back. It's an existential horror because I am where I am and will always remain so. But to get back... Change your level of magnification.
Now, we come here to an extremely important principle, which is the different points of view you get when you change your level of magnification. That is to say, you can look at something with a microscope and see it a certain way. You can look at it with the naked eye and see it in a certain way. You look at it with a telescope and you see it in another way. Now, which level of magnification is the correct one? Well, obviously, they're all correct. They're just different points of view. When we examine our bloodstreams under a microscope, we see there's one hell of a fight going on. All sorts of microorganisms are chewing each other up. And if we got overly fascinated with our view of our own bloodstreams in the microscope, we should start taking sides. Which would be fatal. Because the health of our organism depends on the continuance of this battle. What is, in other words, conflict at one level of magnification is harmony at a higher level. Now, could it possibly be, therefore, that we, with all our problems, conflicts, neuroses, sicknesses, political outrages, wars, tortures, and everything that goes on in human life, are a state of conflict which can be seen in a larger perspective as a situation of harmony?
Yeah, again, makes perfect sense. Perfect sense. I buy it. I absolutely buy it. But, like, again, how... Oh, I don't freaking know, man. I just don't know. I don't know. Let me onto this ice planet. I want to see what the story is here. Okay, are these all going to be ice continents now? Large kelp. Let's go down this way. Yeah, again, this is just... It's crazy, mind-blowing stuff, and I love it. It's killing me. It's killing me to listen to it and to hear all of it, but I just love it. I love hearing about this stuff. I love reading about it. I love studying it. It just feels good. It feels good for me. All right. Ringed ice planet. So we need to get back the Golden Gate. I don't know. I just don't know. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to look. I don't know what to do. What the hell is this thing? What are you? A rock planet? Okay. Now, can I actually get this rock moon? No. Alright. I'm not interested in rock planet. What was I on before? Like, blue planet? No, I don't want to go bigger. Ringed ice planet, green planet, rock planet. What are you? Alien planet. Ooh, let's check out alien planet. Let's see what's on here. Okay, what is this? What am I? Tell me what I am. I am alien continent. Okay. Alien continent. Looks like there's not much otherwise here. Let's go down in here. Find some new stuff. What am I? Obsidian crystal. Let's see how obsidian crystals dance, shall we? Ooh, I like the way obsidian crystals dance. That's nice. That's real nice. All right. And, anything else down here? No? Alien continent. So let's see what's on an alien continent. Are there indeed aliens? What the fuck is this? I am Hilaria? This is a bird of some sort, you say? What on... Okay, I was about to say what on Earth, but clearly that would be a stupid thing to say right now. So I am not going to say what on Earth about this. I'm just going to hop in and scope everything out. I am now the planetary nipple, of course. The planetary nipple sounds like this. Oh, that's weird. That's real weird. Okay, we've got multiple planetary nipples now, or at least planetary kind of things. I can join up with all of these plants and be very happy about it. Alright. Trees. Join me. Yes. This is a much faster way to add things.
And you can say, aha! At last, I see. I got the point. I've seen how all this makes sense. But what this insight depended upon was your overcoming the illusion that space separates things. That is to say, the space, the interval between your body and mine. The interval created by birth at one end and death at the other. And then after somebody's death, then somebody else's birth. These are events with intervals between them. And normally we regard these intervals in time and these intervals in space as having no importance, no function. We tend to see the universe itself as really consisting in all the stars and galaxies. That's what it is. That's what we notice. But the space in which all this happens is sort of written off as something that isn't really there. But what one has to realize is that the space is an essential function of the things in the space. After all, you can't have separate stars unless there is a space around. Eliminate the space and you will see you couldn't have this phenomenon at all. And vice versa. You couldn't have the space. They wouldn't be there in any sense whatsoever if there weren't the bodies in it. So the bodies in the space and the space are two aspects of a single continuum. They're related together in exactly the same way as a back and a front. And you just don't get one without the other.
So I guess like I thought, it's really funny what that one just said. Sure is sunny right now. Too bad I left my sun umbrella back at the house. What's funny about that is that after the last one, I said, yeah, I get it. And then the next one comes up and he says, so you say you get it, huh? Well, you don't. You don't get it. You are the same. You are the same. And there is no getting it. The getting it is like a construct, right? Of course you get it. Of course you get it. You are everything. Right? I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm not stoned enough for this. That's the problem. Everything I know and everyone I love will eventually be lost forever, except me. I will keep going on and on. Excellent. Excellent. I like these little rainbow lizards. They're fun. I think I might stay as them for a bit. Everything around here is changing rapidly, except for me. I've been the same. I'm the same I've always been. I never change even a little bit. I even stay the same age every year. You wish you could be as boring as me. Dance, lizards. Yes, baby lizard. All right, let's go, baby lizard. So good. So good. There's so much enjoyment in just that little mechanic. I love it. All right, what's up? This is my favorite spring. It's really magical. There are moments of great beauty in its little rhythms. All right, I want to get down. Get down on it. I want to get down as far as I can go. See what kind of alien bacteria might be here. Right? Sound good to you? Sounds good to me. Lower. Don't forget that you can transform into other things. Right. Right. What if I transformed right now into a galaxy? I'm a tiny galaxy. Oh, no shit. I can go into that. Okay. All right. What if... What do I hold? Similar, same. I hold down? I hold up? All right. What if I did this? Okay. I'm in a brand new place, and I'm a brand new thing. What am I? What am I? Alien planet? Question mark. Great. New places. Always new places. An ice planet. Okay. Can I... Oh, this is still a sun. It's just green. Alright, what are you? You're some sort of... Oh, a dwarf planet. Okay. Alright. That's a thing to be. Ooh, let's go over there and talk to you. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. I just want to find people, dude. I want to find, like, a big city, like a full-on city. But this game is so huge and clearly procedurally generated that I don't know if I'm ever going to actually find that. Like, it might just be random. But then again, isn't part of this game about not being random at all? Right? Isn't that a part of it? Isn't that, like, part of the sensation we're supposed to get and understand from this game? I do not know. Space is connective.
So the moment you see that intervals, that space is connective, you can understand at once how you are not just to be exclusively defined as a flash of consciousness that occurs between two eternal darknesses. That you consider that in the darkness that comes before your birth, there was no you, and in the eternal darkness that follows your death, there is likewise no you. And I'm going to discuss these matters not by appealing to any special spooky knowledge, as if I had been traveling on the higher planes and knew all my previous incarnations and therefore could tell you authoritatively that you are much more than this individuality. I'm going to do it on a basis of complete common sense, that everybody has access to the facts.
Every time I get one of these narrator moments, I'm speechless afterwards. Like, what do you say? What do you say about shit like that? Like, unless you have some sort of real understanding of it, and I'm not sure that I do. I don't think that I do. I don't believe in myself insofar as understanding this kind of thing. So right now I'm trying to comprehend. Definitely trying to comprehend all of this information and let it be what it is, let it live and let it affect me. Yet, at the same time, I understand and I accept that I am playing a game and that there is some sort of outcome expected. Allow me to sing you the song of my people. Yeah, Rock, you did great. You did really great. I'm impressed. That in a game, we are expected, or rather, I live by one simple rule. The less stone-like you are, the less likely I am to beat you up. That there is a set of parameters at play here that I am supposed to be doing. You know, I'm supposed to be, you know, winning or losing or at least playing, trying to accomplish something. And to me right now, that is like getting all of these things, filling out my list, right? That's very important. Can a lily pad leave the water? That is the question. It looks like it can. I've done it. I'm going. I am lily pad, and I am conquering heretofore unclaimed territory for lily pads. Look at me go. Look at me do this. I'm gonna talk to this plant. What's up, buddy? I'm a tree, so sunny days don't bother me that much. They used to when I was younger. Ha! Cute. That's cute. Alright, lily pad, what can you become? Okay. I can become this guy and move quickly. I am a Bismarck palm. I have great compassion, but it's just a pretext to gain respect, honor, and power. I am coming to terms with being doomed. Ooh. That is a great rock. A great large rock. Splooshy splooshies. I need to become larger then, do I not? Aha, another target. Okay. I'm still kind of coming to terms with what this game is, exactly. It is a learning experience, for sure.
A pattern of immense complexity. And what you call yourself as a living organism, say, I am my whole body at the very least. Now, what is that body? That body is recognizable, and I recognize my friends when I meet them again, and you recognize me. Although, the last time any of you saw me, I was absolutely something entirely different from what I am now. Just as the flame of a candle is never a constant. The flame of a candle is a stream of hot gas. Only you say the flame of the candle as if it were a constant. Well, it is a recognizably constant pattern. But in exactly the same way, we are all constant patterns. And that's all we are. The only thing constant about us at all is the doing rather than the being. It's the way we behave, the way we dance. Only there's no we that dances. There's just the dancing. There is no thing that whirlpools. There is the whirlpool, and in the same way, each one of us is a very, very delightfully complex undulation of the energy of the whole universe.
Yes. So, like, he has said that there are no things, right? That a thing is a construct, that everything is what it is, and everything is everything, as it were. And yet, that there is no, oh, I'm a planetary system, right on, that there is indeed what am I trying to say here? That there is no identity of a thing outside of the thing itself. There is only the whirlpool. It, this thought, but do not asking for me. I love, will keep going, bye, bye, bye. Okay, cool. That's good. That's a good way to look at things. There, little speck of light. I think you've done a good thing there. Let's go to the cloud down here. Let's do it. Off we go, towards the cloud, to see what this cluster of stars has to say about life. Look at us go. Look at the edge of the screen also going a little wonky, which is kind of cool. Okay. Oh, such great distances. Such massive distances. This is an interval of time. This isn't an interval of time, but a fixed eternity. The entire process is flowing inside and out of everything at once, with infinite detail and without a single imperfection. When you search for meaning out here, you'll find only yourself. So, this Golden Gate thing, like, it says to go back, but I don't know how. Rather, it's said to go back, but I don't know how. I do not know how to go back. I am lost. I am truly lost. And the only way that I can think of, perhaps, is to continue moving forward, continue going until I arrive at the place in which I need to be. Right? I do not know. I am confused. I am lost. And in being lost, I feel like I've become kind of sad.
Because life is basically a game of hide and seek. Because life is pulsation. On and off. Here it is, and now it isn't. And by being this pulsation, we know it's there. Now, from those very tiny fast rhythms, which give us the impression of continuity, there are also in this universe immensely slow rhythms. And these are very difficult for us to keep track of. And they impress us and depress us as our own life and death, as our coming and going, which goes for what is to us such a slow pace that we can't possibly believe that it is really a rhythm. We think of it as our birth, as something quite unique that could never occur again because we're so close to it, you see, and it's moving so slowly.
Yeah. Yeah. Again, it's getting difficult for me to listen to the narrator while also playing the game and trying to search for things. Look at this. But in the end, I am still creating. I'm still making things. And I can indeed get bigger here, apparently. I just have to point myself in the correct direction. There we go. Alright. Cool. Upwards. Alright. I am back on Desert Planet, which is something. This may be the place that I was. Have I not been this plant before? Sediveria, I guess not. I am now corn on this desert. In a place. Really? I haven't been this before either? Oh, there we go. You're new. Oh, I'm a duck. Quack, 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 quack. Look at me go. Okay. All right. Okay. I want to be bigger than duck. Where do I go to become bigger? Okay, back to the pyramid. And straight up again. I'm gonna see where this cycle takes me, right? Ooh, some fresh things. Yes! Ah, I can strike the fear of God! Okay, and I can perhaps hot air balloon? Oh, I can get all these different clouds. Cool. Oh, I can become a massive storm. That's amazing. Oh my god. There's just so much. There's so much in everything, everyone. There's so much in everyone as well, everything. I want these hot air balloons. I want two hot air balloons. Come to me, hot air balloons. I need you in my life. I need you. Slow down and wait for me. What is this that I can talk to up here? I can't tell where the wind starts or ends, but somehow it keeps going. Oh my gosh. I just adore this. I just adore it. All right, Rock Continent, what can I become from you? Oh, what's this? City Continent, yes! 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 Let me in there! Let me into City Continent. No, not kelp! Not kelp! City Continent. Yes! And whatever this is, fishies. I don't want that either, but I do want whatever this is. I'm a school of salmon, and I am going to go over here, and then I will come back to the City Continent and have a look around, because I want to see what people are like. I want to see what people say. I want to become people, and I want to see people dance. I want all of that in my life. And this game is giving it all to me for the low, low price of $15 on the PlayStation 4, ladies and gentlemen. So do it. Make it happen. Play this game. It's great. Oh, it's so good. You're going to feel like an asshole for playing it. You're going to feel like some pretentious piece of garbage jerk. Shenanigans, art, crap. But dude, it is so worth it. Rock Continent, Sand Continent. Okay, I'm just gonna become a continent and find that City Continent again. Look at this, process of growth.
Process of growth. The basic process of biology is one in which lower orders are always being superseded by higher orders. But the lower order can never figure out, or only very rarely figure out, what the higher order is that's taking over. And may see it as a terrible threat, as total disaster, as the very end. But can never be aware that the principle of growth always has and always will continue. Because that's what's going on. But you never know what the next step is going to be. Because if you did know, you wouldn't take it. Because it would already be past. Do you understand this? That any certainly known future is an event of which we can say you've had it. And in that sense, it's past. When we play a game, the outcome of the game becomes certain. We at that point cancel the game and begin a new one. Because the whole zest of the thing, which takes me back to the idea that this whole thing is a hide and seek game, is that you don't know what the next order coming up is.
Huh. Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. That does make sense to me. This idea of when you know something for certain, it is very difficult to actually make that certainty happen. I'm a stoplight. Buzz, buzz. Look at all these things that I can become here. So many things to become. Yes! I am buildings. I am all of the buildings of this city. And I am going to... I am revolting. The buildings are under revolt, everybody. There's been an earthquake. And a lot of my building buddies died because of that. But... this is pretty much all buildings, so this is good. This is good. Alright, let's become this guy. Here we go. Alright, good. I am a Georgian home. I am... back to street lamp. I need to become something greater, right? A bus. Perfect. Let's go, bus! Through the city. Let's do it. Yeah! Oh, look at us. Oh, we connected! Oh, cute. This is so cute, I love it. There's only one way to get by around here, and that's to crush everyone and everything around you. I love living in a city. I've always wanted to live here. I sort of need noise to relax. The wind, the cars, all of it's music to me. Yeah, whatever. I want all the vehicles around you to sing you up. Alright. We're going to become vehicles that are less than we. I am school bus. I am old car. I am normal car. I am trash can. Look at all this stuff, dude. Wheelie bin. I am dumpster. I am phone. There's so much in the city. There is so much. Payphone. Okay. Go to here. Come on. Here we go. I am trash can. I am phone booth. No, I don't want to go any deeper than this. I want to go bigger than this. Because eventually I want to get inside of the buildings. I want to meet people. That's what I want. A scanning system based on sensing danger.
We have this rather myopic way of looking at things. And we screen out from attention anything that is not immediately important to a scanning system based on sensing danger. But quite obviously, you as a complete individual are much more than the scanning system. You are in relationships with the external world that on the whole are incredibly harmonious.
True.
The energies of life in the form of temperature, light, air, and food, and so on, are streaming through you all at this moment in the most magnificently harmonious way. When anything is constant, it says, okay, that's safe, it's in the bag, needn't pay attention to that anymore. And therefore, we eliminate systematically from our awareness all the gorgeous things that are going on all the time, and instead only become focused on the things, the troublesome things that might happen to upset it. Which is all right, but we make too much of it. We make so much of it that we identify our very selves, I, ego, with the radar, with the troubleshooter. And that's only a tiny fragment of one's total being.
Huh. Huh. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I buy that. I get into that. That's good. This game is great, dude. This is so good. Like, because not only do I feel like I am playing a game, like I am accomplishing things, you know, trying to become all of these different objects as much as I can. I am a piece of gum. I am used gum. Holy shit. I am flashlight. I am VHS cassette. I am everything, man. I can't believe how utterly beautiful this garbage is. Like, I can't believe it. And look at this. I have been those cockroaches before. I have been the roach before. It is not indeed where I started, but it is close. It is close to where I started. The black ant is close to where I started. And that's where I'm trying to go. Oh my god. Oh, it feels good. That whole commentary. Rough grass is close to where I started. Like, I've been making my way along this one direction now for 13 years now, but have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. Me too, buddy. Me too. And frankly, I'm used gum, and that is it. Like, but I am also matchstick, which feels good, I think. And I am also, oh no, I've gotten stuck. Oh shit, matchstick. Shit, dude, you gotta get out of there. Okay. Oh, yikes, that was close. I want to be Cookie. But I cannot be Cookie. Okay, but at least the grass has more freedom of movement. So let's go. Let's fucking do this, dude. Let's fucking do this. Let's get a little bit bigger, actually. Oh, back to Fire Hydrant. I don't think... I mean, like, there are obviously people here. But I don't know where to find them. I don't know how to do that. How do you do that? Aha, maybe this thing will tell me how to do that. Let's chat. Let's chat, playing card. An event upon which this whole cosmos depends.
You very soon realized that your existence is not something that is just the hopeless little creature that's suddenly confronted with a great big external world that goes gah at him, you know, and eats him up. Every tiniest little thing that comes into being, every minute little fruit fly or gnat or bacterium, I will go so far as to say, is an event upon which this whole cosmos depends. This thing goes both ways. It's not only that every little organism which exists depends on its total environment. The reverse is also true, that the total environment depends on each and every one of those little organisms. So that you could say, this universe consists of an arrangement of pattern in which every event is essential to the whole thing. Now, we screen that idea out of our consciousness in exactly the same way that we screen out the perception of space as an important reality. Just as we pay attention to the figure and ignore the background, so we see one way of looking at things, namely that the organism is very frail against the environment. It lasts a long time, the environment, but the organism only lasts a short time. What do you mean the environment lasts a long time? What does the environment consist of? Just a lot of little things. When you get far enough away from all the organisms and the little bits of things, you see the environment in another scale of magnification. But actually, the whole thing is arranged in a polar system where the enormous depends on the tiny and the tiny depends on the enormous. And you get a relationship between these extremes, which can be called a transaction. They always go together. So in this way, we are always, as it were, overemphasizing a certain aspect of our experience.
Yeah, that's cool. This is, man, obviously this is deep stuff. And I wish I were more educated on the topic so that I could go more in depth. Like, the only thing I can do is ask questions, I guess, which, I mean, I suppose that is all any of us can do ever, and strive to be the kind of person who can dive into it and try to answer those questions. But it isn't easy, is it? It's never easy to answer questions. To actually legitimately answer a question is never easy. But from a gameplay perspective, right now, I still feel so trapped. The game has asked me to return from whence I came. And I wonder if the game is saying that we can never. I doubt it. I feel like I could have plotted my course and eventually returned, right? I feel like I could have done that. But I don't know. I do not know, ladies and gentlemen. And in that lack of knowledge, I leave you for this episode of Everything. Thank you all so much for watching. You know I appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you later. I will see you around. I will see you next time. I can't wait to play more everything. And I can't wait to do it with you. Have a great day. Bye.